5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. It would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice in its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister. The look it was giving me.
What are you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better.
Sir?
Gina!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
This son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show. Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Imagine living on a property where you have several encounters going on, you're hearing vocalizations, these creatures are walking up to your house at night, and you're afraid to tell anyone. You've already started out making the mistake of telling people, and then you get nothing but ridicule. Tonight's one of those interesting encounters, because that's kind of how the encounter starts off, and you'll see as a progression of the encounter what actually takes place. This one's an interesting encounter, though, because there was a shooting that took place on the property. And generally what happens when one of these creatures are shot is there's usually revenge. There's usually people talk about their problems going from small problems to now big problems. This one's a little bit different. I want to welcome Lou to the show. Lou, thanks for being on the show. I really appreciate it.
Hey, anytime, Wes. Thanks for having me on.
And if you would, go ahead and start from the beginning. Tell us about what you were doing at the time of your encounter. And if you want to give a little bit of background on it, that's okay too.
Yeah, no problem. Basically, grew up in Central Jersey, youngest of three boys, and my the two brothers. And we grew up in the central area part of New Jersey. And when I was about 4 or 5, this was in the 70s when I was that age. When I was about 4 or 5, my parents had gotten divorced. Mother had gotten, a little bit later, gotten a new man, and he was like the opposite of my, our biological father was, one of those guys that, Mr. Reserved, craziest thing he probably ever did was, drink a beer and play Monopoly or something. But this next guy was like the complete opposite, and I think that's why, And, anyway, he turned out to be pretty abusive, put it mildly. And so one of the things my mother would try to do, she knew that we didn't like them, a couple of years gone by. I don't think she really knew exactly what was going on to this day. But one of the things she'd like to do is when we were off from school, is just to get us all, at least me and my middle brother, out of the house for the summer. So my neighbor across the street, we were really close with them. And the one boy was my age, and the other son they had was the same age as my middle brother. And they had an uncle who lived up in the northwest corner of New Jersey, which is the one area of New Jersey that looks pretty close to where you live. It's all forest, and that goes from, if you go west from there, you're going to go into the forests of Pennsylvania. And if you go north from there, you'll go into the forest in upstate New York. So it's a really big forested area, and he had a small horse farm up there that backed up to a couple national forests in those national forests, you got the Kittitini Mountains, there's swamps, I mean, everything. It's just, like I said, it just goes on and on and on. I guess the first time I heard it, I was probably about 8 or 9, and it wasn't every night. We'd be up there usually about a month. We'd stay with them. And we had a boat up on Lake Opacon, so there was like a million things to do. We'd shoot 22 rifles and, you know, walk the woods during the day and go fishing and stuff. It was a lot of fun. But there was one day in particular, we were hanging out at barbecue, and it was during the day. And we started hearing screaming. And basically what it sounded like to me at the time was just people, but like loud people, screaming. One would scream to our left, and then there'd be a response to the right. One would scream to the left again, and it basically back and forth, which, you know, didn't seem too odd, I guess, but it was more the reaction of the uncle and his two sons and his wife that made it bizarre. And as soon as they heard that noise, they immediately sort of kicked into action, essentially. And the way his property was set up, he had a horse pen closest to the woods. It was the larger of the two pens. And then he had one closest to the house. And the first thing he asked us to do with his sons was get the horses from that far pen back closer to the closer pen. So, you know, we're helping as much as we can, and we're trying to, like, find answers, because they're, like, frantically trying to get these horses. And I'm like, dude, what the hell is going on? And they really wouldn't talk about it. So we get the horses in, and then the next step was he had a bunch of, maybe 4 or 5 dogs, and they were on tie-outs. And we had to move those dogs from the far tie-outs to the tie-outs, basically right up against the house. So once all that, we completed all that, the screaming continued, and finally we sat down to eat. And me and my brother just kept pressing them. And then finally the uncle said, he goes, all right, here's the deal. The street that they lived on, it was only about 6 houses, and they were pretty spread out. And he said that one of the women that lived in one of the houses had these 3 sons, and that they were very dangerous and crazy, and they would go in the woods, drink, cause ruckus, and bother all the people on the street. And he said he just didn't trust them, essentially. And said they were like vandals. So as weird as it sounded, when you grow up in New Jersey, there's no such thing as Bigfoot, you know? Like, it's just the farthest thing
right from
anybody's mind.
Yeah.
And I probably did see, you know, the Patterson film when I was a kid, and I probably looked at it, and 5 minutes later forgot I saw it type of thing, you know? So anyway, that only happened a few times during the day. It would mostly happen at night. And when it happened at night, and I'd say if I went there 30 days, this probably happened maybe 10, if I'm guessing. You know, didn't happen every night, that's for sure. And I noticed when it happened at night, they seemed even more nervous than they did during the day. So,
when you say it happened, do you mean the vocalizations, the screaming?
Yes. They would start vocalizing again. And it was mostly just sounded like screaming. And like I was telling you, Wes, the best way I could attribute it to was when the recordings you got from Texas, when it sounded like just people screaming back and forth.
Yeah.
There wasn't a lot of that, like, Ohio howl. And I don't even remember hearing anything like that. There probably was a few whoops, like, mixed in, but it was mostly just the screaming. So that was, like, the gist of it, you know, when I was a kid. So, but I noticed when these vocalizations would start again, and it happened at the nighttime, the family seemed to react, like, a little stronger to it, like, At nighttime, we'd build a fire over by the barn, which was probably 300 yards from the house. They had a pretty large piece of property. I was thinking 15 acres, but I double-checked on that. It was more like 22, which I know isn't, like, huge, but in Jersey it is.
Yeah, that's a
lot. So we'd make a fire at night and sneak beer and just hang out. And when those vocalizations would start, we'd immediately have to stop that fire out, get the dogs and bring the party to, like, right up by the house. And you could just tell they were nervous, you know what I mean? So anyway, you fast forward a bunch of years, and now I'm 19 at this point, because we went up there to, this continued through the years, like I said, off and on. But it was kind of an uneventful experience.